For the collective.
Finds playing that ball into Ferreira. A little bit of hesitation there from Fonsette. Ferreira laying it back in on an empty net. And Jonathan Lewis has his first career international goal.
Lewis. We have with us head coach of the Trinidad and Tobago men's senior team, Coach Terry Fenwick. Coach, your first game in charge, away to the USA, a 7-0 defeat. What are your initial reactions to this?
Well, obvious disappointment. We knew this was always going to be a tough game. They've got a terrific side. Across the board, their development program over the last 5 to 7 years is churning out top class players. But having said that, I was really disappointed with the result, the scoreline. We went into the game with the game plan, and I can only think that some of the senior players, it was too much. The occasion, the USA, big team, we didn't have the big attitude, the big strength, the big strong arts. And we were very poor in the opening stages, and it set the tone for the game.
Coach, despite the fact that you've had a local squad in training over the past 6 to 8 months, the fact that you came into the squad, you really had 2 days with your squad. How much does an impact do you think that had on what we saw there on the pitch?
Well, I think you've got to recognise the best bits of football that we played. If there is an upside, if there is a positive, it was in the second half. I thought Hackshaw came on and made a big difference. Good defender, played it well from the back. And there were local guys in the middle of the park. We started to play a little bit of football, pressed forward, got the penalty, which was squandered. But I saw that as a positive. It's up to me now to cherry pick the ones that are going to be of value and move on to the next stages.
In saying that, you took the gamble to start with some of the players in the first half who you had a chance to see for the first time.
Yes.
And you had to take that gamble against the Americans. So tell us about that.
Well, I took the gamble because they're playing in the US here, MLS and USL players. And I didn't see that experience coming through. I thought we crumbled very early. The first goal, we had a game plan, how we were starting the game, first 15 minutes. And senior individuals within the team mechanism switched off. And we give the ball away cheaply in areas that we'd already discussed we wouldn't do so. And that started us off all wrong. And I thought that throughout the first half was very poor. Our performance was terrible in the first half. I thought second half, when the younger players come on, the local guys that have been training for a while, that have got a game plan, they actually stuck to it. And we started to play a bit of football. We made one or two little chances, got the penalty. I've got to take a bit of positive out of that. And again, we bring these players in. First time I've seen them in a game. I like some of what I saw, but obviously there's a great deal of work to be done.
Coach, you mentioned so far game plan twice. Can you share a bit of us what your game plan was going into the
game? Well, we recognise that the US here, they're very energetic. They're an under 23 side almost, and they press very quickly from the front. So the game plan was to turn them round early doors. Let's get them running back towards their own goal. So we could be the ones pressing. And you recognise from the first goal, Leland Archer trying to place a ball into midfield, which they capitalise on, bang, goal within minutes. Instead of what we'd planned ahead, get it in behind, let's pack in and close them down. So, listen, we've got to take that on the chin. They are a very good side. They're the best team in the CONCACAF region. They're the best team because they put lots of time, energy and money into their development process. We've got to get some sort of development going so we can bring our kids through better than we're seeing at the moment.
For this match, you had over a handful of debutants, first time at international level.
Yep.
Your reactions?
Well, I had six players start the game that I'd not seen before. I've seen them on bits of YouTube and other information that I've collected from them. They're playing in decent leagues. I expected more, I expected better. And we just didn't perform. It was like the occasion was too much.
Now your focus remains March 25th, opening World Cup qualifier against Guyana.
It was always our focus. We've got to move on from this, take what positives we can from it. There were some positives, and then positives came from the younger guys coming through that have been working hard. We had some nice little passages of play. We're playing against the top class team, Sean, and they were calm and calculated at the back. Their passing and movement, a lot of the things that we've been working on, they do like very well. And that was us trying to get in behind fullbacks, trying to get in between centre-backs and fullbacks. And I just thought they give us a lesson of what we've been trying to work out ourselves.
You had a few words with Greg Berhalter after the game. Obviously, yep. He expressed his enthusiasm about going forward with his team, and also he's wishing us the very best against Guyana. He mentioned that to me. And what was discussed between you guys? Because obviously he understands our situation.
Well, the thing is, Greg and the guys in the US, I've got to roll my hands up. They've done a wonderful job over the 5 to 7 years that they've put the development program together. The US in there, we've got players at Barcelona, Bayern Munich, Chelsea, all over the world playing. And these guys are between 20, 23 age group. So they are doing a wonderful job with their development program. Sean, we haven't got a development program in Trinidad. Nothing. There's nothing at grassroots level. There's nothing at 13s, 15s, 17s. We haven't got that. So by the time the players get to my national side, there's still a hell of a lot of development to be done. So we've got to try and correct that.
You have 2 days left in Orlando before the team returns to Trinidad. What is your plan now? What are you hoping to accomplish between now and the next few weeks leading up to the 25th?
Well, there's going to be a lot of disappointment. Tomorrow morning, we'll have a chat. We'll get some points of view with the players, how they felt, and then what I saw in the game. I'll bring out the positives that I did see, particularly second half. The Hackshaw situation, I thought he'd done very well. But we've got to be better than that. We had a game plan that we didn't stick to, we didn't start with. And that is nothing more than mentality, tough mentality. This is what we're going to do, and do it. And we didn't do that.
Coach, I want to wish you the best going forward for the qualifiers. And we'll take the positives out of this, as you said, and good luck going forward.
Thanks, Sean. Thank you.